I'm going to show some of our favorite new spatial analysis tools, starting with a new feature that will change the way that you analyze topography. This 3D scene shows the rugged terrain of Sequoia National Forest with the giant sequoia trees dotting the landscape. In 2015, a wildfire swept through the area, burning over 151,000 acres. Forest fire behavior is actually influenced, or can be influenced, by the topography of the land, and knowing where different features or landforms are can aid in fire response. So, the new Geomorphon Landforms tool uses a DEM to automatically derive some of these features and landforms. So let me show you the results that have been symbolized for fire response. Calling attention to the ridges in red, spurs in blue, and valleys in purple. Ridgelines can act as a natural fuel break, serving as a strategic feature to combat high-intensity fires. And here, we can actually see where the fire stopped at the ridge. Next, let's explore air pollution data over the state of California using the new hotspot analysis comparison tool. This data set shows the average particulate matter levels aggregated into 50-kilometer hex bins. I ran an analysis to identify hotspots of particulate matter in 2005 and in 2016. To compare these 2 years, let's focus on these three regions in Southern California. I can toggle between the layers going from 2016 back to 2005, and we can see that there are some changes happening, but what exactly? In ArcGIS Pro, we can use the new hotspot analysis comparison tool to quantify these changes. The tool calculates the difference between the 2 years. Let's take a look at the results. The first output from the tool shows the similarity values between 2005 and 2016. The lightest color shows where particulate matter levels were the most similar. The second output from the tool shows significance level combinations, which tells us what direction the hotspots are trending. The light pink shows areas that have stayed the same, light blue shows areas that have cooled, and red highlights where particulate matter levels are intensifying. This is a really powerful tool for understanding two time snapshots of your data.